everyone. My name is Harry Saufa. I'm from AeroBoForce team from Indonesia. Wanna presentate our video presentation for RoboCup Worldwide 2021 for RoboCup Junior Rescue Simulation Go Space category. My team consists of 4 members. The first one is myself, Harry Saufa Bien Fawaz, and you can call me Haritz. Then Ike Maya Setia, Satria Yoga Ilham, and the last one is Hima Aulia Rahmania. About the task, I am Haris Alva as a leader and programmer with Ike Maya. Our job desk is to program all of kind that we need for this competition. Then Satria Yoga as a strategy planner. His job is to compiling algorithm for obstacle avoidance, avoid trap, and boundary, and etc. And then the last one is Hima Aulia as a project manager. Her job is to team support, documentation, publication, and editing. Problems, method, and results. In this competition, we have some problems that we need to solve it. And the problem number one is the robot have to avoid from entering the trap zone and avoid the trap accurately and securely. And then the robot need to move swiftly and effectively, so the duration will be much shorter. To solve that, we have some method. We giving a more varied program of action, such as reverse action and turning at the proper speed. So when the robot detect the trap zone, robot will reverse, will turn back and go to right place. And the result is the robot can dodge traps precisely without requiring lot of time. And then problem number two. While the robot moving at high speed, the robot must be able to effectively avoid obstacles within the entire area. To solve that, we have two methods. The first one, we set the evasion distance range precisely so as not to hit obstacles ahead. And number two, by adding some action conditions, like in case the robot begins approaching obstacles, the robot's speed will automatically be decreased. And number two, when the robot is close to the obstacles, the robot will perform an evasive action at the appropriate speed. And the last one, the robot's evasion direction is aimed at a more empty and spacious place. And the results, robot's obstacle avoidance will be smoother and better. Problem number three. The robot must be able to respond and immediately pick up the super object before the object's location signal has completely disappeared. Then, after getting the super object, the robot must go on to deposit box swiftly. To solve that, we use dead reckoning or line of sight autopilot so the robot can respond the problems quickly. For the example, there's a picture in presentation. The robot start at position X1, Y1. And then the target position is in X2, Y2. First of all, we calculate the delta X by X2 minus X1. Then we calculate the delta Y by Y2 minus Y1. Then after that, we calculate the alpha by tan inverse delta Y divided by delta X. So from alpha, we can find the beta by minus the 90 degrees by the alpha, so we can find the beta, and then we find the way to go to the target. And the result from this is the robot can easily pick up super objects on the map and quickly bring it to the deposit box. Then problem number four. The color of the boundary line is nearly the same with the color of the warning area on the map, which creating a little bug in robot program. So the color is red is 236, green is same 236, and DB is 0. To solve that, we add a radius value in robot advanced condition program so robot will move accurately. And the result from this is the robot can alter the direction of its movement when it will approach the boundary without requiring to detect the color of the boundary. So the conclusion of all of this is the robots certainly have numerous errors and in some cases can react to certain circumstances. So we as developers must discover a simple and exact ways to unravel the issues and use the best strategies to program the robot. By using these methods, which we described above, we can minimize the errors what we found earlier, so that the robot can work smoothly and accurately according to what we expect and what we want. And by participating in this competition, we can develop new knowledge about virtual robot programming, and also makes us more experienced, so that in the future, we hope that we can be more innovative and developing more awesome creations. I think that's all from us. I am Harith Saufa from iRobo Force Team from Indonesia. Thank you for your attention.